Chira gives us another long, wandering look. Or wondering look. Well, if everything's alright, I suppose I'll go. Yeah, yes, we're fine. Goodbye. Too cheery. Chira just blinks at us and leaves, shaking her head as she goes. I feel like I've been underwater for 5 minutes, finally taking a deep breath. She can't see you? Of course not, sweetling. Sweetling? You summoned me, so you have exclusive rights to this eye candy. That's the best kind of rights. So that way, when someone walks in on you, it looks like you're just having sex with nothing and you're just a fucking crazy weirdo. That's the best idea. I'm just for your viewing pleasure. I slump down into my chair with a heavy sigh. How many close calls can I really have with expulsion? Or is this sort of thing just everyday nonsense at a school that teaches magic? I really haven't figured it out yet, but I haven't heard any other students opening up portals to hell. She can't stay, Sophie. I mean, can she do anything? She's so mean. A real statist, if you ask me. I can be that way, too, if that's what you're into. I'm not into anything! Oh, and unexplored desires, my favorite. We do have a small problem. Just a small one? Yes. I don't see a way here to unsummon her. It's just the summoning ritual. She looks over the paper like maybe it was written in invisible ink, but no. There's just no way. Which one of us said what's the worst that could happen? I'm not taking the heat for this. Oh, that's bullshit. All things considered, it could have gone worse, right? We could have summoned some powerful demon hell bent on destroying the school or something. Barry looks nice enough. Sweet, innocent angle. Yeah, no. Senpai noticed me. Cool. It's great. That sounds so completely wrong with... Yeah. Demons can't ask Senpai to notice them. What the fuck is this bullshit? That's fucked up. Are we almost done with this fucking exchange? Alright. I'm not very good at that one. I'm working on it. All my power was spent summoning her. There's no way I'm going to be able to keep practicing. I guess we might as well go to dinner. With that? No one said she had to come. I want to come all night. Yeah, there you go. You're so cool, demon. I think I like this demon who was just introduced more than I like most of the characters I've seen so far. I don't know why. Maybe it's because she's a sex demon, or maybe it's because she just likes to do innuendos, and I'm like, fucking great, whatever. It's a breath of fresh air. Look at it this way. Maybe she can help us with our trial somehow. But she's not listening. Instead, Charlie groans and storms out of the library. In my modest professional opinion, she really needs to get laid. Yeah, I mean, why not? That looks so good. Eerie eyes my plate like a puppy begging for scraps. I can't believe you're letting her sit with us. No one can see us. How am I supposed to stop her exactly? You could ask. She said we're her masters, so can't we just tell her to go away? Is that how it works? Nope. Cool. See? So why don't you losers sit with your classmates? Some of these people are really attractive. They don't really know anyone. Those are all initiates of the academy. We're just apprentices. She's like, oh, you're just fucking low levels over here. It's not funny. We're just as good as anyone else here. Not good enough to get into the school, though. To be initiates. I've never seen Charlie get so worked up before. Darling, if you were just as good, you'd be sitting with them. Besides, that's not what's funny. You two are so determined to send me away when I could help you. Can't wait to help us get some fucking demonic magic. I mean, I am a demon. Don't you think I might have some insight into magic? I think you're wicked and probably here for no good. Eerie looks sour. I don't even know if it's Eerie, mind you. Could be like Aerie or some shit like that. Like, I don't fucking know how to say her name. I'm just going with what I first said. So if I'm saying it wrong, too fucking bad. I'm sorry. You should wash your tongue, shouldn't you? And to think, I thought about introducing that tongue to mine. Cool. Now that's never gonna happen. Sophie, look. She kicks me gently under the table, turning my attention towards the teacher's table. He stares right at us as he strides past, worry knots itself into my stomach. He passes by so close his robes nearly brush my arm. Could he see her? She laughs again. You think he was looking at me? She tugs on my piece of hair, a piece of my hair. He was definitely checking you out. Must be those, I don't even know how to fucking say that. Cherubic cheeks? I don't know. I'm bad at reading. I don't know what the fuck I play these games when I'm so bad at reading. Oh wait, because people really just want to watch this most of the time. So that's usually why. I don't mean the ones on your face. Oh cool, my ass is just the best. Pretty sure he was looking at me for an entirely different reason. Though at this point, I'd probably prefer it was checking me out. A gaggle of students swarm up behind us, talking loudly with each other. I'll tell you later. I stab at my tray with the fork. Well, since I can't find a way to get rid of her, I guess I have two friends now. Yay, we have a new friend! Why am I the only one who gets stuck with her? You can handle her better than I can. It just makes sense. What does that even mean? Because you're hostile towards her? Is that what you mean? Even Charlie looks a bit remorseful as we squabble over her like a kid neither parents want in the divorce. That's fucked up! Jesus Christ! It's fine. I can just go outside in the dark by myself. Alright, bye! Don't be dramatic. Yeah, but more drama though. At least don't mope around forever. Make it up to me by having sex, right? I think you know how. Not even a little teasing? What kind of boring school is this? They're all getting started. Yeah, why not? A blinding puff of white smoke suddenly fills the room. Oh, cool. About time more fan service. I needed more thumbnails. Great. Amazing. What did you do? Yeah, just did some fun. I stare between both of them, my jaw hanging open. Sophie. Right. Sorry. I clenched my eyes shut. I didn't see anything. I saw everything. Everyone just needs to unknot their panties for a second. She slides behind me, hands on my shoulders, suddenly as she starts to massage them. How do you like it? What the fuck? Wait, what? That's the wrong one, isn't it? How do you like it? So, what the fuck? That feels good. Give my clothes back. Fuck, I don't know which one I want to say. I want to say give my clothes back, but this feels good, but... Fuck, let's go with give... Yeah, it feels good. Nothing like a little nudity to work out the stress of life. You should join us. It looks a little uncertain. Are you really going along with this? She lifts her hands up. Hey, whatever you get up to at night is totally your business, but leave me out of it. She gives us both a look as she leaves. Great. Now I'm alone with her. I feel like that was the quicker path, but I don't know. Actually, I'm curious about that one. Let's save it here real quick. Let's see how long that one would have went out for a little bit, because I'm fairly curious. Are all people around here so dull, or is it just you two? I'm getting out of here before she starts touching. Oh yeah, no. So I chose the longer route then. Cool. Then spins on her heel to face me. Why don't you come join me, Sophie? I'm good. We'll have a good time. Alright, cool. That sounds fun. Charlie, she's not really that bad. You're just not exactly her speed. What a pity. Don't look so sad. I thought you humans would be more into sex, you know? You live such short lives. That depends on who you're talking to, actually. Especially your kind. My kind? Magi. Always looking for some reason to get themselves killed, aren't they? I changed my mind. You and Charlie are exactly the same. Ooh, let's have a threesome then. We're not having a threesome. Well, what am I supposed to do then? I don't know. Sleep? Evil doesn't sleep. It was a joke. Never mind, but really, I don't need sleep. Does that mean you have to watch me sleep? She snorts. I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm not exactly glued to your side. I can entertain myself for the night. Maybe in your bedroom, trying to be quiet but unable to help myself. This is the best thing. I'm not moaning. It's going to be a long year. I convinced Erie to leave my room for the night. Just leave. I think she went to spy on the other students and hope that some of their nights are more sweeter than he did mine. But if she stays around, they might just end up that way. I know she's a demon, but I shouldn't find her attractive. Good evening, Sophie. Pity Erie didn't stay for this. I think she would have liked it. Has Mage Warden, Master Mage Armin, mentioned anything to you yet? Nothing. I think the Master Mage is more than willing to overlook this transgression, and Mage Warren will be convinced if he sees your talent. Try not to worry too much. Now relax. There's this again. Hand slides over mine, she puts me to sleep. If she hadn't, I don't think I would have managed it myself. I feel like, yeah, her falling asleep isn't like that. It's because it's like, oh, you were just... You just spat on me. What do you want? Roll over irritably, glancing up into strangely colored eyes. Do you mean to help wake you up? Her hands slide between my thighs. What are you doing? Two forward. A nice outfit there, actually. Nice one, nice. Didn't know you got different outfits. And what are you wearing? This little thing? I thought you might like it. No need to be dramatic. All you had to do was say no. Will you just tell me why you woke me up? I'm bored. Alright, cool. Crawls off the bed too, and onto me with a gleam in her eye. Again, what's with the other bed, by the way? I'm still kind of curious about that one. Squirm helplessly. I have school. It's a Sunday. There's no school on Sunday, even in the demon world. There are schools in the demon world? No, ergo, no schools on Sunday. I guess that works. Too early for bullshit. Whatever. The point is, I have to train. There's a trial we're trying to prepare for, and we're spending every day working for up to it. Yeah, you mentioned that yesterday. I didn't really care. Oh, and oops, I don't care today either. I mean, alright. Just have fun being around people you don't care about what they're doing, I guess. That much you can do. You get studying to do. Can't fuck about. How did I get summoned by two of the most boring, prudish people on the planet? She follows me towards the bathroom, sliding between me and the doorway. It's not like I haven't figured it out, you know. What are you talking about? Your little secret. What? How could she? She couldn't. There's no way. You're bluffing, and not well. Can you move out of the way? All right. Whatever you say, Sean. Oh, there it is. Has been around, but she's already vanished. When I walk in, Charlie's feet are hovering a couple of inches off the ground. Yeah, she's levitating again. Practice, yeah. Since it's good for your controls, plus one of the things I'm actually better at than you. It comes with a certain sense of pride. I seen Erie this morning. She ran off while I was getting ready. Keeping track of your demon wife is your problem, not mine. She's not my demon wife. I'm not? Not yet, I guess. Now I'm just insulted. Speak of the devil. She better not say anything to Charlie. I try to give her a stern glare, but she just smiles at me with those sharp little teeth. You look tense, Sophie, darling. How about a deep massage to work some of that out of your system? I'm here to train. Can you at least let us do that in peace? Can't wait to just train a bunch. Go through the steps again, Charlie trying to offer her best advice. I even try jumping to get a head start, but my feet return stubbornly to the ground. No. You're doing it all wrong. You're trying to drag yourself up, like your magic is a string you're tying yourself to. You gotta push upward from the center. She pokes me hard in the chest, which doesn't help my concentration. Come on. Like you're filling your boobs with helium, only it's magic instead. This can't be serious advice.